Reda, there's no respite for the market. There's a tad bit of respite, though, on Dr. Reddy. So if you pull up the intraday chart, that you'll see there is some bit of an uptick, but it's still down about 6-odd%. I guess from a blow like that, it looks difficult to actually recover outright. So still trading about 6.5-7% lower. The big story over there is that the US FDA issued Form 483 to the company's Bachupally unit with 11 observations, actually contains four observations which are repeat. So Ekta Batra is here to line up the implications for us. Ekta.
Well, yes, it is the Bachupally site, which is around 45% of the total US formulations for Dr. Reddy's, which has received 11 observations. We knew about the total number of observations, but now we know the details of these observations. Out of that, four are repeat, and in fact, one of them has been repeated all the way back since 2015 as well as 2017. Remember that this particular site was inspected by the US FDA in April of 2017. At that point in time, by the end of the year, they had received an establishment inspection report indicating that the inspection was closed as well. Now, remember, for Dr. Reddy's, though this particular plant is currently around 45% of total sales, they do have around lesser dependence when it comes to future filings. So around 10 of their ANDAs are pending approval out of 100 from this particular site. However, there is fear that maybe there could be an escalation, but the street is probably not anticipating an escalation to a status of import alert, only because they do not have severity of observations here to that extent. So for example, data manipulation, data integrity. So maybe, yes, you could probably see it escalate further. And that is obviously the street's fear in terms of slowdown of US sales and maybe, you know, some amount of impact of current US sales. But as of now, the street expects that these observations are still resolvable, but the timeline of resolution could be longer.
Ekta, thank you very much for that. The market's picked up a little bit. It's, down 75 now, which means maybe, 25 odd points off the lows at this point. I mean, Sumera, the big talking point really is not the markets. I mean, I've been talking to people, and there's just one thing which people are wondering, and wondering quite sort of loudly and actively, is what should we expect after yesterday's deadly attacks that we saw in Kashmir, which took the lives of 37 paramilitary forces. We heard the story about Arun Jaitley earlier in the day. So we know something is coming, but what exactly is going to be the move forward? Let's get some perspective going. Vinod Sharma is political editor at the Hindustan Times, and he's joining us right now on that. Mr. Sharma, thank you for your time. Prashant here.
Yes, Prashant.
So what's the chatter in Delhi? Could you tell us? I mean, what should we expect really?
Well, there is a lot of public outrage, and there is a common refrain is that Pakistan should be given a befitting response. Now, this attack is way bigger than the one that was that had happened in Uri, and nobody took credit for the Uri attack. But in this case, Jaish-e-Mohammed has taken credit for this attack. And that links Pakistan directly as a host of Azhar Mahmood. It is well known that Jaish-e-Mohammed has been receiving patronage from the Pakistani establishment, namely the army and the inter-services intelligence. And it is also self-confessed by Prime Minister Imran Khan that he and army are on the same page. Now, the big question is whether Pakistan will do something by way of assuaging the feelings in India, do something against Jaish-e-Mohammed, against Azhar Mahmood, or whether he's capable of doing anything against them. Because these groups, which have been nurtured and trained and given the kind of status, you know, that they have in their society, this is all thanks to official patronage. So that Frankenstein's monster has become too big for any political party or any politician to handle unless the army is totally behind them. And the army perceives these people as their assets, you know, as their assets for proxy war. It is very unfortunate that they have resorted to this kind of a thing. And I think the Indian reaction, the countries united, the government has got full support of the principal opposition, which is the Congress. Rahul Gandhi came out, Prime Minister, former Prime Minister Manmohan Singh came out, and they said that they are with the government on whatever it decides by way of a response. Now, the response, I think, will have to be demonstrative. If Pakistan remains silent and accuses through its silence with Jaish-e-Mohammed, then the response of India will have to be demonstrative. And whether it will be a kinetic or non-kinetic, non-kinetic will also obviously be there on the diplomatic front. But what kind of a kinetic response, that is a military action, would it be? We'll have to see. The surgical strike option, most of the experts who have been expressing their views since yesterday, doesn't seem to be very viable, because the surprise element would be there, and the other side would be prepared. So something bigger, perhaps, and something bigger, what could that be? Maybe more by way of a demonstrative overt action. We'll have to wait and watch. But something will have to be done by this government in order to assuage popular sentiment. Actually, even people who are pro-dialogue, namely someone like me, feel deeply disappointed by what has happened. And I think that this is the final bullet through the heart of any peace initiative with Pakistan in the near future, and maybe also in the distant future, because I don't see Pakistan mending its ways sometime soon.
Okay, that is a pretty comprehensive sort of take on the entire issue. Mr. Sharma, thank you very much for joining us with that. I mean, so essentially what Mr. Sharma is saying, it has to be, whatever has to be done and something has to be done, will be pretty demonstrative. He said something like a surgical strike potentially is less likely because that element of surprise is in there, but something will have to be demonstratively done, either militarily or otherwise. So we'll see what really comes off. But the market, meanwhile, is off the lows by quite a bit. Actually, I was pointing to that before I moved on to this the other story. We were down 75, which means we were off about 25 from the lows. We're down 65 now. So there is some more pullback which has happened as we speak. Yeah, 63 lower now. Well, let's put the Bank Nifty up quickly. Take a look at what's happening there. Yeah, 2% down. I think there is some pullback underway in the bank space. The small cap index is down 1%. Mid cap index is down about 1.25% there also.